Friends, today I'm going to tell you the story of a demoness called Kalaikini. Now, it so happened that there was a person whose wife was barren. She was unable to get him a child. And in those days, people used to marry again. And the second wife became pregnant. Now, the first wife was very jealous. So she gave poison to the second wife and the wife died. And in the next births, they got births as cats, dogs, does, and each birth they were enemies to each other. In the birth, the last birth, the first wife became the ogress Kalaikini, and the second wife became the wife of a very rich man in Savatthi, and she was having a small child. Now this ogress saw this rich man's wife and the son, and she was after them, and she wanted to kill the child because of the long enmity which has transgressed over many lives. Now it so happened that the second wife was a lay devotee of the Buddha. She went with the child and kept the child in front of the Buddha and said that this ogress Kalaikini is after me. Buddha with his powers brought Kalaikini in front of him, and he explained to both of them that it is a long-standing enmity. He also talked to them about their earlier births because he was able to understand with his magical powers, and he said the following verse: Nahi verena verini samantida kudachana averena cha samanti esa dhammo sanantano, which means hatred is indeed never appeased by hatred in this world. It is appeased only by loving kindness. Listening to this, the ogress Kalaikini became established in Sotapatti Fruition. That is, she attained a level of enlightenment and the long-standing enmity was stopped. Then I look at this sutta. I understand that it is truly the law of nature that if we have enmity towards anybody, then it doesn't get appeased. In fact, it is a difficult thing for us only because we keep thinking of that person inside. Whereas if we are able to forgive that person by our metta or karuna, then becomes much more easier. So enmity can only be appeased by loving kindness and metta. May all beings be happy.